I had my first child. And when I came back to school, I wasn't going to school for school. I was going to school for my boy. My granddaddy was a high school dropout, my daddy, and I was a high school dropout. And I figured if I at least graduated from college, that he would have to graduate from high school. I would be an example. So when I came back with a vengeance. I was driven by a purpose. I'm telling you, you'll never be what you're supposed to be. You'll never have what you're supposed to have. You'll never ball out until you got a purpose for why you do what you do.
The people who blew up, they blew up because there was something that was going wrong in their life, and they took that pain and they turned that pain into something. You will never ever go to class, and you guys are spoiled. Do you know what it's like to go to class in Michigan in December? It's 10 inches of snow and they don't close the school, and it's minus 10 degrees and you still gotta go up and go to class. How do you go to class when it's 10 degrees and 12 inches of snow? You know how you do it? Because you know your mama broke and she working two jobs and taking out a loan for you to go to school. I laugh at kids whose parents are broke and they up there partying like everybody else. Your mama broke. You went to school, listen to me, some kids when they go to school, they just going to school to keep the legacy alive. They mama already got money. Some of us, we taking out loans to help our We taking our loans and sending it home so people can pay rent. That money ain't even going to college. And we still going to parties. We still clubbing. Listen to me, nothing against fraternities. But I've had students. One dude had a 3.2 GPA and got in a fraternity his freshman year, and it went down to like a one something. I'm saying, what kind of brotherhood is that when you got my man up at 2 o'clock in the morning washing your car and going to get you groceries when you should be helping this kid to study? Now he can't get into college of business, but he got Greek letters. He didn't come to school to get Greek letters. That's a bonus. He came to school to get a degree. Because if you walk out of here without a degree, you came up short. So you gotta be driven. I'm driven, y'all. I get up every Monday and do TGIM. I drive home, get back to the airport, hour and a half drive, back and forth almost every single day, because I'm driven. I want my son to have a better life than I had. I don't want my son begging like I had to beg. I don't want my son to ever think he got to sell dope or he got to steal from the mall. I'm driven. I want my daughter to know what it's like to have. I'm driven. When I was at the Michael Jordan Classic the other day and I opened up that whole conference, people like, E, you speaking at the Michael Jordan Classic. How do you feel, bro? You made it. I said, I'm hungrier than I've ever been before. Now I want to speak to the Pistons, the Knicks, the Boston Celtics. I'm driven now. I'm hungrier than I've ever been before. Why? Because I tasted it now. I messed up. In my book bag, I got the first check I ever got from Nike. I used to buy Nikes, now I got a check with my name on it. I ain't even put it in the bank, but I want you to see it. I'm driven. When I got that first check from Nike, I was like, ooh, I'm on the payroll. That means I can get another check. And the next check I got was double that check. I'm driven. What drives you? Because you ain't going to go to class just to go to class to hear somebody teach. You got to go to class with a purpose and say, I don't care if he's boring or not. I got to get through him, and I got to get through that class, and I got to get through that boring stuff so I can get to where I'm trying to get to.